Hallo, jeg er Jason Rano, og velkommen tilbage til What Remains of Edith Finch. Vi er på toppen af det her, hvad hedder det her, Light Tower, et eller andet. Vi er på toppen af huset, og vi er på vej mod toppen af huset. Og jeg fandt altså en indgang her sidst igennem vinduet, så lad os prøve at se, hvor den fører hen. Hvem skulle bo her? Kan jeg komme ud igen, Vanette? Det kan jeg godt. Jeg skal lige prøve at se, hvem det er, der skulle bo her. Det tror jeg, vi kan se ude på døren herude på den anden side. Kunne vi ikke det? Hvem er det, der skulle bo her? Milton. Det er Miltons. Miltons værelse. Lad os lige kravle herinde og se, hvad vi kan finde herinde. Hvad laver han? Milton, han laver små modelhuse og alt muligt. Det ser sgu da meget fedt ud, det her. Okay, han er god til at tegne i hvert fald. Det er helt sikkert. Hvad kan vi der?
Milton Finch in The Magic Paintbrush.
Okay, vent. Jeg tror, jeg har den. Hej, vent. Cool, mand. Det kan jeg huske, jeg lavede som barn også på de der post-it-blokke. Det var helt vildt hyggeligt. Skal vi nok have tegnet Milton på, kunne jeg forestille mig.
I was 4 when Milton disappeared.
Okay. Det var ikke meget, vi fik at vide om Milton. Andet end han rigtig godt kunne lide at tegne og male, åbenbart, tror jeg. På det også at se en udsigt, han har haft heroppefra. Det er jo helt fantastisk. Lad os prøve at se, kan vi komme ned igen her?
Mom spent months searching for my brother. Then she sealed the doors.
Det er simpelthen, at moren bare giver op, når hun ikke kan finde børnene. Så har hun bare lukket dørene af. Og tænkt, nå, dem kan vi ikke finde. Fantastisk. Godt, lad os se, om vi kan komme ud her igen.
Whatever Milton had found in the house, Mom didn't want it getting out.
Jeg tror, vi skal tilbage, hvor vi kom fra, igennem det der skolelokale. Ja, vi kan kigge igennem det her.
After Milton disappeared, the only thing he left behind was a room full of paintings.
Der har vi ligesom været inde at kigge på. Super nice. Men prøv lige at lægge mærke til her engang. Der står altså faktisk ikke noget, der står ikke noget dødsårstal på. Der står 1992 til et eller andet. Han er bare forsvundet. Så vi ved ikke rigtig, hvor han er. Det bliver altså mere og mere indviklet, den her familie her, synes jeg. Kan vi komme herop? Det kan vi godt.
Mom definitely blamed Edie, but I think Louis blamed himself. After he graduated, he just spent more and more time in his room. Until Mom got him a job at the cannery. Everyone always told me to stay out of Louis's room. Except Louis.
Hvad er det her så? Det er måske vejen ind til Louis' værelse, tror jeg. Så vil jeg sige, hvad vej kommer vi derind? Det gør vi her.
Louis's room smelled very, very familiar. That part of him lived on.
Bedste gæt er, at Louis han var ungkarl. Prøv at se her, der er vandpiber, og der er hasplanter på væggen, skulle jeg sige. Cool, mand. Ja.
Louis and I spent a lot of time playing games together, but he was surprisingly bad at them. He died a lot.
Det er brev til Dawn.
Dear Mrs. Finch, as Louis's psychiatrist, I can understand your desire for an explanation. As I see it, the trouble began in January, shortly after we convinced your son to seek treatment for substance abuse. Newly sober, I believe Louis first noticed the monotony of his daily life. He kept working at the cannery. But he withdrew part of himself. In our sessions, I saw the same behavior. His mind began to...
Kedelig job, tænker jeg, ikke? Stå og hovedet og fisk hele dagen.
Wander.
Åh, vi skal styre ham igennem.
I asked him to describe it.
Mens vi laver det her, det er også svært.
He said he started small. Imagining a labyrinth. He'd feel his way about. Then something moved. Bats. And toads.
Oh, det er faktisk ret svært at styre det her. Jeg skal både styre musen, og jeg skal styre manden i labyrinten her.
And things that have not names. He knew it was all in his head. But he took it very seriously. I had hoped he'd find himself. But he found something more. I worried about him then, daydreaming at the cannery. I spoke with his boss.
That's smart there.
But he said Louis had become a model employee. Methodical, tireless, focused. Like a whole new Louis. So I let him go on. I even encouraged him. It seemed very promising at first. He told me he'd made a new friend. On the edge of a city he named Louis Topia. He built the city up slowly, brick by brick. Then he made musicians. And songs for them to play. He talked about starting a band. And he was always humming something.
Gik jeg vist forkert, tror jeg.
Every day his imagination grew stronger. He no longer spoke at the cannery. But his chopping was as reliable as ever. Then one day it struck him. That all the cheering crowds, even the stones under his feet, were all in his imagination, so he could do whatever he wished. He held an election for mayor. and he won. They begged him to stay, but his mind was already wandering. It became a game for him.
Skal jeg blive ved med at hakke det der fisk, eller hvad?
Immediately push on. New Louisville. St. Louis. He started drifting away from our reality. Minneapolis. Until one day he forgot to go home from the cannery. Even as his mother pleaded with him, part of Louis kept sailing on. In Louisburg, he heard rumors of a handsome queen. The queen was on her own quest for sinister serpents.
Godt nok noget af en fantasi om Louis.
He followed the sound of her silver harp. His chase led him to a golden palace east of the sun and west of the moon. Even then, his logic remained sound.
Se, nu er der ikke noget som helst tilbage af virkeligheden, altså der hvor vi kolder fisk, andet end den fisk, jeg har i hånden. Så han er virkelig ved at blive sindssyg.
He knew the world was all in his imagination. He was so proud of having created it. In his own eyes, he'd become something greater than a king. For someone who'd never known success in the real world, I think it was overwhelming. And then it struck him that the real Louis was not the one chopping salmon, but the one climbing the steps of a golden palace. My imagination is as real as my body, he told me. It was hard to argue with him.
Okay, jeg tror, jeg er Louis nu. Nu skal vi lige finde ud af, hvad han skal. Det var her, hvor han arbejder, tænker jeg. Det er hans skab. Jeg næsten gæt på det her, det er Louis' skab.
He began to forget the world we know. I think it pained him to remember Louis, the cannery worker.
Vi er op til ham her, eller hvad? Det tror jeg, vi skal.
He began to despise the man with a royal contempt.
Det her, det er Louis. Jeg er ikke Louis. Det her, det er Louis. Hvad skal vi med ham? Louis? Hallo? Står bare der og laver ingenting, prøv at se. Han laver ikke noget. Han laver ikke noget. Men hvad skal vi her? Kan jeg vide, hvad vi skal? Skal vi derop, eller hvad?
I still thought I could save him.
Det skal vi. Okay. Det havde jeg faktisk aldrig gættet. Vi skal herop.
Even after he said he was being crowned king over all the lands of wonder. The palace would be packed with his companions.
Okay, det rabler virkelig for ham, hvis det er det her, han tror er virkeligheden.
Including the wise Calico, who'd insisted on advising him.
Se, der er en kat. Det går galt.
And the rest I think you know. Mrs. Finch, your son was a kind man who will be missed by all of us who knew him.
Det kan man ikke kalde en arbejdsulykke. Okay. Han fik simpelthen, jeg tror han fik kottet hovedet af dem, hvor den hakkede fiskens hoved af.
My brother was really cool. I wish you could have met him.
Så kom Louis på. Vi mangler Dawn, vi mangler Edie, vi mangler Calvin. Og så mangler vi Sanjay. Umiddelbart, så er det dem, vi mangler fra familien. Det er det eneste, vi ikke har set endnu, i hvert fald. Men jeg er overbevist, om vi kommer. Men ved I hvad, det her det var alt værd noget for den her gang fra What Remains of Edith Finch. Jeg ved godt, det ikke var særlig meget, men det er bare sådan, det er nogle gange. Det her det er altså bare det spil, og vi prøver altså at spille det til enden for en gangs skyld. Hvis du synes, det var hyggeligt at kigge med, så synes du, at du kan smide den her video et like, så bliver jeg super, super glad. Og så må jeg også rigtig, rigtig gerne skrive en kommentar, så bliver jeg nemlig også glad, at jeg svarer på alle, der skriver under mine videoer. Tak for nu, og på gensyn i næste video. Vi ses. Hej, hej.